will give them to you. He will kill all the men with your sword.
Yes, sir.
But don't kill the women and children and animals. Everything inside the town you can take as plunder for you to use and eat. God, your God, gives it to you. This is the way you deal with the distant towns, the towns that don't belong to the nations at hand. But with the towns of the people that God, your God, is giving you as an inheritance, it's different. Don't leave anyone alive. Consign them to holy destruction. The Hittites, Amorites, Canaanites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites obey the command of God, your God. This is so there won't be any of them left to teach you to practice the abominations that they engage in with their gods, and you end up sinning against God, your God. Now, can you just praise Him for that word?
That's right.
I never was a fighter in high school. Never was. Everybody that knew me knew that I would not fight. And I was bullied every day in junior high school by a young lady that was in home economics class with me. And every single day she had it out for Benita.
Uh-huh.
Every day I found dish towels hitting me upside the head. When I was not looking. And of course I would get mad. Would find her hiding my utensils at test time. Every day for probably about 3 months straight. I got hit upside the head in home economics class with a wet dish rag. And all of my fellow classmates would laugh. They say, Benita, you let that girl bully you.
Yeah. Wow.
But I'm going to tell you what I did one day.
One night.
And then not only that, she, when I get out of class, she would take my money. Take my lunch money. And in that very hour, the same time, the same And then when I got out of class, I said, all right. She said, meet me outside of this classroom. Because when you get to your locker, I'm going to beat your behind. And you are not going to be able to even speak after I get done with you. And I stood outside the door and I shook a little bit. And all my classmates said, Benita, what you going to do? I said, I'm going. She started. You're not going to die in the battle. I know you're afraid. I know some of you are facing some mountainous situations. Some of you are facing some doctor's reports. You're faced with a Goliath. You're doing the right thing, sweetie. You're praising God. Some of you are faced with Goliath. I imagine when David went out before Goliath, he was trembling. He was scared because he was so much smaller. He was looking up to his mountain and saying, God, if you are with me right now, the enemies don't take me out. And I've got people depending on me. Because I accepted the fight. I accepted the challenge and nobody else did. Some of you accepted the challenge that nobody else accepted. You said, Lord, I'll go. And your enemy began to laugh at you and say, ha, ha, ha. You mean you're the one that's going to stand up to me? That's what the enemy is doing to us every day. He's saying, ha, ha, you're the one that's going to stand up to me. You know what I'm saying? But David had something that Goliath didn't see. He had the presence and the anointing of God. And that's what you carry tonight. You got a slingshot and you got a bag. And the Lord is saying, go out to battle and don't be afraid.
David said, you know what, I can't use this. So this is not proven. I can't use this. And then I can see Saul saying to David, then if you're not going to use this, then what will you use? He said, I got a slingshot.
Yes, sir.
And I believe that God is raising up a generation of people that will put their confidence in the slingshot. It don't look like much. And Pastor Shepard, what does the slingshot represent? Well, the slingshot represents the spirit. It don't look like much all the time.
Oh, you're right.
But David said, I'm going to put my confidence in the slingshot. I don't know who I'm talking to, but there are those of you under the sound of my voice that if God doesn't do it by the way of the supernatural, then it just won't be done. Your credit can be so messed up that if God doesn't do it by the supernatural, then it cannot be fixed. Your situation can be so dire that if God does not fix it by the supernatural, then it looks like you are at your wit's end. But how many under the sound of my voice know that it's not by power, nor is it by might, but it is by my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. If you're here tonight and you're not saved, if you're here tonight and you don't know Jesus and the pardon of your sins, if you're here tonight and you don't have a church home, then you are in the right place at the right time. Come on, clap your hands, maybe you might be right.